Hello, welcome to Boca Today Live. We have John Fay here. He's head of Americas at New Edge. Thanks for being with us today.
Hey, Joanne.
Well, he's on a panel later today, the clearing universe post Dodd-Frank. Lots of issues with that. Dodd-Frank's been a big topic at this conference. But what are the main issues with New Edge?
Well, I think, first of all, New Edge is the world's largest broker. We're an agency broker. We only deal for our customers. So we come at the post-clearing, post-Dodd-Frank clearing universe a little differently than a lot of our competitors might, who have big proprietary businesses and big swaps businesses. The most important thing for our customers is open accessibility to clearing venues in the U.S. And I think that the primary purpose, one of them, of Dodd-Frank was to introduce competition into the markets for clearing and to reduce systemic risk by diversifying that risk among many brokers. So it's important to our customers that there are multiple clearinghouses for OTC derivatives that become exchange listed and traded, and those clearinghouses themselves have accessibility through many different brokers.
There have been a number of rulemakings that have been proposed in this area. How do you think they're taking shape?
Yeah, well, Chairman Gensler spoke yesterday at the conference about the rulemaking proposals, and I think that the clearinghouse rule is really fundamental to a lot of the other rules that are in process, because unless there's a clearing mechanism in place, there'll be no place for exchange-traded derivatives to clear. So that's kind of a building block. And the proposed rules as it stands now allows clearinghouse access to brokers with $50 million of capital. The European regime is much more closed. Brokers require either $5 billion or $1 billion of capital. So our feeling at New Edge is that the number is somewhere in between for clearinghouses, because what customers want from brokers really is a broker with sufficient capital and sufficient access. And so somewhere in the middle of that regime, I think, is the sweet spot for clearinghouses.
John, you touched on an interesting point, and that is that the rules differ in different countries. And is that a concern, and do you feel that regulators are, I know there's been a lot of coordination among them, but the rules are different.
Yeah, I think the regulators have a lot of work to do. The U.S. regulations seem to be ahead of the European regulations, and there are very big differences in terms of accessibility. So we could wind up with two separate market structures, which I think would be bad, because most of our customers are global. They think globally, they trade globally, they clear globally. And so I think the rules must be very close in the final taking. There can be differences because of practice or culture or currency, but in the end, they need to be a broad-based set of rules so there's a level playing field.
One more thing, and this is the whole issue of cross-margining. I mean, this would be a good thing to, as we bring in this broader range of asset classes into clearing. Mm-hmm. The regulators have touched on it a little, but what are your thoughts?
Well, Joanne, that's a great point. I mean, there is a rule in Dodd-Frank, Section 713B, for those of you who want to flip through your rule book, which require the CFTC and the SEC to work together to allow for cross-margining between securities products and futures products. Now, this rule has been on the back burner of the regulatory process because of all the other work that has to be done first. But we think it's one of the most important incentives to allow people to take OTC securities and futures and trade them and clear them centrally to have a margin offset, for instance, between an OTC swap and a Eurodollar, or an OTC swap and an index. So I think that those kinds of efficiencies will actually incentivize people to bring their OTC business onto exchanges. And certainly our customers feel that way.
Right. Well, John, thanks for being with us. Stay tuned for more on Boca Today Live.
Great. Thank you, Joanne.